Wasn't that magnificent, everyone?
Thank you.
It's hard being glamorous like us, isn't it? That was a fantastic performance. What's that song actually about?
It's about growing up on the road. And I guess it also has a lot to do with my background. You know, I'm like a mutt. I'd say I'm part Spanish, part Lebanese, part Italian. So I'm a mixture of many different cultures. And I think that I've been my entire life just...
A real wanderer.
Yeah.
In lots of ways.
Something like that.
Now, I think your musicians are a very interesting collection of people. Where did you pick them all up?
They I picked them. Actually, they've been with me for quite a while, almost 10 years.
Wow, really?
Yeah, yeah. They're like a family to me. We are a family.
Oh, that's good. So you all get on all right?
Yeah, we do.
No punch-ups and the tour bus or anything?
You know what? I don't like tour buses.
Oh, no.
No, I get dizzy.
No.
That's the only thing.
I don't like them either. I drive myself, folks.
Because I like to drive.
Yes, you know? I love to drive as well. Absolutely.
I don't like to sit on the back seat.
No, no. In control. Absolutely.
Women in control.
On your new album, you're mixing a lot of musical genres, so well done. Just tell me about a few of them. I have to say, I have listened to it. My favourite line.
Really?
It's absolutely, I loved it. I particularly loved Mon Amour. Because it's got a great line in it, which says something like...
There's a rock
like,
chick inside you, huh?
Yeah, there is a rock chick. It's a long way inside. There's a thin one a long way inside as well, but... I love that line, I hope your toilet doesn't flush. That's really right up my street. Yeah. And I just love to hear that sort of kind of raw stuff. You mean, because so many songs are little wiggly romantic and... Yeah, I hope your toilet doesn't flush. I'm going to use that. What actually inspired the title track of She-Wolf, then?
Well, I think that there's a She-Wolf inside of every woman. And I understand women's plight a little bit better. I understand my mom today much better than probably 10 years ago. And, yeah, but I do also feel that we all have an animalistic side, a part that is very... primal and instinctive and basic, and that part that we hide from the rest of the world, and that we try to deny it and sometimes repress it, you know.
Yeah.
But it exists, it's there.
Let's just have a quick look at your clip of She-Wolf, because it's slightly saucy. You're a bit of a saucy.
Saucy.
I'm so jealous that you're saucy.
I like that word.
You like saucy, yeah.
I'm going to use that
too.
One.
Yes, you use saucy and I'll go, hope your toilet don't flush.
That's a fair trade.
Let's have a quick look at a clip from She-Wolf, shall we? Showing your real bottom there.
Sorry.
Is that your real bottom?
That's my real bottom, of course.
Yes, it was marvellous. No, but I wondered if you had a skin suit on or something, so you didn't have to show your proper bottom.
No, that's stockings. Yes. I'm wearing stockings. Yes. Yeah.
And what do your mum and dad think about the saucy bits on your videos?
No, they were the first ones to actually see watch the video. I wanted to show it to them first to get their blessing, because you know, without mum and dad's blessing, we can't do anything. So, my dad found it very artistic. Yeah, he was very, very much impressed about my flexibility, and he didn't know I could actually split like that. He was very, very much happy with
it. He is impressed.
Yeah, he was impressed.
He was impressed.
So
he should be.
And I was surprised. So that was the first blessing. My mom was a little harder to convince. She was very worried about her neighbors. And what they were gonna say back in Barranquilla, my hometown. But I explained it to her. I explained to her that I'm a grown-up woman, you know, and I've always been very coherent in the way I express myself through my music, through my videos. Probably 10 years ago, I would have not been able to shoot a video like this one. But now I felt it, you know. I felt like showing my legs. You know, they're a little short, but they take me to places. And it was not. I said to myself, this it's now or never, you know.
Yeah.
This is the moment to show my little legs.
No one can stop me.
Exactly. And and my mom used to have great legs too. She didn't get a chance to show them, so I guess she was with me on that one.
Mum, get your legs out. And was it good to work with Wyclef Jean again?
Oh my God, I would do it 1,000 more times if I could. He is just lovely. He's a great human being. We both grew up in the developing world. We both grew up witnessing so many things that we share and we do have in common a certain point of view and ideologies and things that definitely make the work easy and more pleasant as well when you are sharing the same common space as well, you know. So
and
he's
great,
a great
to work with someone that you like as well,
yeah,
that you
yeah.
feel an affinity with. Yeah. Now, Hips Don't Lie is the best-selling song of the century. Yes, indeed, ladies and gentlemen. Have you Have you actually given a copy to the music teacher who thought your voice sounded like a goat?
No, actually, I never heard of him again.
Good. Serves him right. Now,
but, you know, when I won my first music contest, after he denied me the possibility of making part of his choir in school, I brought to school my little trophy and I rubbed it on his nose like that. And then I said to him, so what do you say now? You
know? Well done.
So that was my little sweet revenge. But...